There's nothing wrong with this equipment, Captain.
Don't you have better things to do with your time than to examine my equipment?
Absolutely not.
There's nothing wrong with this equipment, Captain.
Don't you have...
No sign of malfunction, Captain.
And they'd better stay that way.
Why do I feel like I've suddenly become a trespasser?
There's nothing wrong with this equipment.
Let's see. The ship is in an emergency, and you're using your precious time to examine my cabinets. Real efficient use of time, Jim.
There's nothing wrong with this equipment, Captain.
Don't you have better things to do with your time than...
Nope.
There's nothing wrong with this equipment.
Of course there's nothing...
Grouchiness level, 101%.
Young human male in average physical condition.
McCoy? Young?
Young human male in good physical condition. Young human male in good physical condition.
Okay, good, good, average, we're all young.
Young human male in good physical condition.
Oh yeah, it must be nice.
Young human male in excellent physical condition.
Excellent. Alright, let's get out of here since there's really nothing we can do. The only thing I can think is back to engineering. Surprise, this is... We have life support. This is accessible. Why can't we get to it? Analyze everything.
Access panel functioning normally, Captain.
We might go through here, actually.
Nothing wrong with the door, Captain. Atmosphere gauge functioning normally, Captain. Temperature gauge is functioning normally, Captain.
And this thingy.
Engineering status board functioning normally, Captain.
Can we crawl through here?
Nothing to report, Captain.
Oh, this little thingy.
The controls are malfunctioning, Captain. The tricorder traces the fault to a malfunction in the Jeffries tube.
We need to get in that Jeffries tube.
Nothing wrong with the door, Captain.
It's like he's just barely putting up with this. Let's scan everything in here. He won't let us mess with anything, but maybe if we find it some kind of interesting development, I'm not sure.
As I'm sure Mr. Scott will tell you, the engines are running just fine.
Like a clock in a burning house.
Meh.
System functioning normally, Captain.
I could have told you that, laddie.
System functioning normally, Captain.
I could have.
Same here.
System functioning normally.
I could have told.
Human male approaching middle age. In average physical condition.
So, Scotty is approaching middle age, but Bones is a young human male. Gotcha. Let's go this way. Let us enter this. No?
Nothing to report, Captain.
No effect.
I guess we can't go in there.
Shouldn't we go to sick bay if anyone's hurt? This is a bit beyond me, Captain. Shouldn't we go to sick
bay? Oh, he's analyzing himself.
No anomalous readings.
Ensign, attack!
You should report any significant security risk directly to the captain.
Is there a problem, Ensign?
No anomaly.
So he just...
Shouldn't we go to sick bay if anyone's hurt? Shouldn't we go to sick...
If we want to fix these controls, we'll have to get into the Jeffries tube. And if my tricorder is correct, we'll have to seal a hull breach first. We'd probably need to get to a starbase to repair this.
Now what is this?
No, I don't think that's necessary. I don't like the looks of this hull integrity indicator.
This ship doesn't look very healthy, Captain.
Captain, I know we want to prevent the alien from entering into...
Chekhov's right, Captain.
Really don't know what to do. We don't have a lot of places that we can go. Keep thinking about the other... I didn't mean to click that. What about the other turbo lamps?
Says the turbo lift is on the auxiliary control level.
Right.
The turbo lift is standing by, Captain. I can't seem to get any response from this control, Captain. It looks like it's being bypassed.
Are you certain that's where you want to aim that phaser, sir?
Captain, why would you want to phaser the turbo lift? It's our only way out of here.
Yeah.
Captain, you might hurt someone with that phaser.
That's the way he said that. That was funny. Sorry, guys.
Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report, Captain.
At a loss here.
Nothing to report, Captain.
There's a vent. There's a ventilation duct. It'd be cool if we could gas the thing, or, you know, send gas through, or send, you know, one of us through that ventilation duct.
Kirk to Scott. Come in, Scotty.
Captain, the hull degradation is continuing.
Kirk to Scott. Come, Kirk to Uhura.
Captain, the rift is providing some...
If Mr. Spock were here, he'd probably find it fascinating. Keep... Kirk to Scott. Kirk to computer. Kirk to Uhura. Come in, Lieutenant. Kirk to sick bay.
Jim, I'm waiting for that medical scan.
We're trying.
Trying my patience, that is. McCoy out.
I've never had a doctor with...
There are times when he's wet.
Kirk to Scott. Computer.
Ventilation. Damn it. What is this? Wait a second. What is this again?
Captain, the intruder has locked auxiliary control.
The deck integrity monitor. This screen shows the layout on this deck. Turbo lift monitor. It says...
Sheesh. Now we make this tiny little hole.
The door to auxiliary control.
A single life form, non-terrestrial, carbon-based. It doesn't seem to be doing anything to our controls. In fact, it's not doing much of anything.
It's funny though, it looks like it's working the controls. So our medical scan through here maybe?
Captain, I'm getting a sensor reading on the alien. I'm sure Dr. McCoy will find this data very interesting.
Quick, to the sick bay. So.
Here's the sensor scan bolt.
Jim, this says our invaders are Vorians.
Vorians?
But they're extinct. They died out at the time that Cochrane invented the warp drive. They were slaughtered in the Three Systems War.
Jim, I know my history, but I also know my anatomy. The alien in auxiliary control is a Vorian. There's only one strange thing.
What's that?
This creature isn't capable of doing some of the things that you described. It's an ordinary Vorian. No special organs, no unusual brain patterns, nothing that traditionally suggests superhuman feats.
Can you neutralize it, Bones?
Actually, it's a female. Huh. And yes, I know of something that can incapacitate it without harming it. A gas mixture. You'll have to pump large quantities into auxiliary control for it to be effective, but it should work almost immediately.
Cool.
Here's the gas, Jim. Be careful with it. There hasn't been a Vorian in 150 years.
It's a pretty long time.
Well, Jim, when are you going to bring out the rabbit?
The what?
The rabbit you're always pulling out of your hat whenever things get really grim.
I'm afraid I may have used my last rabbit, Bones.
We'll find a rabbit. These guys have anything new to say?
Hello, Doctor. Nice weather, isn't it?
You're a navigator.
Yes, I am.
All right, let's see if we can find anything about Vorians.
Kirk to Scott. Come in. Computer.
Vorian.
Vorians. A race native to Vega 3 with minor psionic talents. They were exterminated by the Antoshi in the Three Systems War.
Vega 3. Antoshi? Alright. Three Systems War?
Three Systems War. A war in the early 22nd century between the Antoshi and the Vorians, in which the Vorians were exterminated.
Well, I'm thinking that this Vorian really isn't behind what happened to Spock. It may very well be an unwitting bystander and or victim, just as Spock was. Is. Alright, so do we try to pump the gas through the hole or go to engineering? I think we should go to engineering to do that. We could always try to transport the gas, but it's locked it out, so I don't think we can do that. Yeah, life support is right here, so what if we talk to Scotty?
Captain, is it...
Scotty, if we hit any more of these ramps...
Actually, Captain, I would...
Alright, let's look at this item. Actually, look at this item.
Vorian gas, engineered to paralyze a Vorian without killing it.
It was engineered very quickly, actually.
A variety of neutral toxin, Captain.
Neutral? Or neural? Alright, let's see if we can pump this into life support, I guess?
Not in there, Captain. Put the gas in the life support pump, then use the controls.
Where's the life support pump?
Not in there, Captain. I may only be chief engineer, but I do not see what benefits that an alien nerve gas can have on our impulse controls.
Captain, I don't think that gas was meant to be used on the impulse engines.
Just enjoying all the dialogue here.
Captain, let's not be fooling around with the deflector controls. I do not know what you've got there, but I've smelled Klingon nerve gas with a better bouquet.
Nah.
I recommend we contain the gas, sir.
But charming smelling poison gas.
I'll pass if you don't mind.
Pass on the gas.
I'll pass if you don't mind.
And so will he. Where's the pump? Is it this?
Captain, please.
It's a very unpleasant smell, Captain. This gas was only meant to be fed directly into a starship's atmospheric system. Let's leave it at that.
So where is it?
Life support control systems. Life support control systems. This monitors... This seems pointless. This device stores special chemicals that are pumped into the ship's atmosphere when needed.
Right.
It is operated by the life support system.
Good, good, good. We'll put it there. We'll put dish right there. Yay!
I wish Dr. McCoy had given me the specs on that gas injection system. It looks like a rather clumsy fit.
I'll do it, Scotty.
You'd think that Dr. McCoy would have some respect for engineering.
Oh, you people. Can we just get along?
Well, here we are. The ship is...
Aye, a tip.
Okay, so now do we do this? Okay.
Let's see how our alien friend likes Dr. McCoy's medicine.
Probably as much as we do, Hikaru.
Mr. Kyle, can you transport me to auxiliary control?
Aye, sir. But I have to remind you how dangerous intership transporting can be. We've really been pushing our luck today.
I'm aware of that, Mr. Kyle, but we have to take the risk.
Yep. Forward a beam over.
Look. Something's happening.
It just disappeared. Well, now we can use the ship's sensors.
I was hoping the alien would have been more communicative. Why hijack a ship that's already about to be destroyed, then kidnap a single individual, and then say nothing about why you are aboard?
It certainly seemed to have the power to destroy us. Why didn't it just kill us?
I don't know, gentlemen, but we'll find the answer soon, I promise.
You know, this mission has killed any ambitions I might have had about commanding a starship.
We have to find out where that alien went. It's the only way to save Spock.
I recommend we use the auxiliary control sensor to see where the alien went.
Right. Okay. And this isn't a vent. For some reason, I remembered it wrong.
You get no response.
I don't want me to talk,
The auxiliary control ventilation duct.
Yeah. Too small for a person to fit through. Okay, so now we got stuff. This is the ship's auxiliary navigation station. From here, the navigator can enter the ship's headings and ready their weapons in the Enterprise's fortunately few space battles. I did read that before. Alright, let's save over, actually.
Save new game. Replace.
Since we've accomplished something, let's just mess with controls.
That's odd. All systems look normal. The aliens haven't touched navigation. What's going on? That's odd. All systems look normal. The aliens haven't touched the helm.
Side of sensors, maybe?
Everything seems to be working. Library computer, external sensors. Mr. Sulu, see if you can find where the Vurian went. Maybe that will lead us to Spock.
Yeah. Do it,
Captain,
Sulu.
I'm detecting the Vurian. She seems to have vanished through a rift in space. I have the coordinates of her last known location.
Well, then we'll find out where the rift is.
Everything seems to be working. Library computer, external sensors.
Captain, we have the coordinates to find the Vurian. Why are we wasting time here?
Because I don't know what the hell I'm doing. Navigation? This side?
That's odd. All systems look...
Alright, well, Chekhov does the helm, so you...
These readings look normal to me. You should have Sulu check them. Captain, everything looks fine. Our course and speed are unchanged. Our weapons are online should we need them. This is a bit beyond me, Captain.
Aren't you a helmsman, Chekhov?
Captain, the aliens have not touched the helm. All systems look like they'll respond normally.
Okay.
Nothing to report, Captain. These readings look normal to me. This looks like a normal course, right, Pavel?
Normal. It's an excellent course. The same one I entered before the alien came on board the ship.
Hmm. So how do we make people start using this thing?
It's odd.
Captain, the aliens... Nothing to report, Captain. Everything seems to be working. Captain, we have the coordinates.
Maybe we have to tell engineering to give power to the engines or something. I don't know.
Kirk to Scott. Come in, Scotty.
Captain, the hull degradation is...
Yeah, it's not working.
Captain, my operations knowledge of the science station is limited. I suggest that either Mr. Sulu or Mr. Chekhov check it out. Both have very strong scientific backgrounds. Let's see, shields are raised. Impulse looks right. Maybe you should let Commander Sulu take a look at this.
Yeah, he's... I'm trying to have him actually use it.
That's odd. Captain, why would an alien take minimal control of the Enterprise and leave its weapons intact? If only we had a target to fire upon.
You just want to shoot stuff, don't you?
Captain, the aliens have not touched the helm.
So...
These readings look normal.
Normal.
Nothing to report, Captain.
How can we do things?
It's odd. All systems... That's odd. All systems look normal. The aliens haven't touched navigation. What's going on? Everything seems to be working.
Captain, we have the coordinates.
Maybe we just need to talk to Sulu to get him going?
You get no response.
Or Chekhov? Wait, my mouse got stuck?
I was hoping the alien would have been more
It certainly seemed to have the power.
I don't know, gentlemen, but we'll find...
Let's move over here so we can actually... talk to him.
Captain, if we're going to rescue Spock, we're going to have to transport to the place the Vurian went.
To another dimension? You can't be serious.
In my opinion, Captain, it's the only way to save Spock and this ship.
Okay, so we're not flying over there. We're going to use the transporter to transport ourselves inside the rift and where we could possibly die of exposure to space and suffocate to death.
You know, this mission has killed any ambitions I might have had about commanding a starship.
Smart man, let's go this way. We'll have to fix that hole someday. Let's go to transporter room then.
Mr. Kyle, you have the coordinates where the alien teleported?
Captain, you're asking me to transport you into another dimension. I may not be able to lock onto you there.
I'm aware of the risk, Mr. Kyle. You have your orders.
Aye, sir.
Here we go. No option given. Transport us to another dimension before we collect our pension. Oh, and need I mention that
Captain's personal log. I have transported to many strange places in my day, but beaming into an alien dimension is something entirely unique. Only the extreme risk to my ship and my friend Spock.
Looks painful.
Caused me to take such a drastic risk.
This doesn't look like a nice place to ease it.
There's the Vurian. I don't see Spock.
He's got to be around here somewhere.
Either in pain or wiggling very happy because it's back home and it's just like rubbing itself in the sand and it's all happy and stuff. Let's look around.
A Vurian. The alien doesn't appear to be noticing you. Strange boulders jut from the depths of this strange planetscape. Strange boulders.
Not these little things.
This gem-like stone has a dull orange luster. This bright green gemstone looks like green-tinted quartz.
It seems significant.
Although it looks like common dirt, the ground in this strange place feels softer, spongier. Each footstep you take here feels strange.
It's made out of what? Moon dust? Moon rocks? What's that stuff that you guessed again? It was like a weird feeling clay or something?
This blue gem looks something like a sapphire, but requires some polish and cutting.
Should we take all the stuff?
This dull yellow gemstone looks a bit like topaz. Strange boulders A pile of blue stones. Although it looks like common dirt, this is as dark a place as you've ever seen. James T. Kirk. He has seen strange places before, but never anything like this. Lieutenant Sulu. This place is one of the most foreboding that he has ever seen. Ensign Chekov. He wonders whether he's going to live long enough to reach the rank of lieutenant.
We'll try to get you there, Chekov.
Ensign Walker. He wonders why his parents had to call him Angus, of all things.
Like the great Angus Scrim. The tall ensign. I guess we can analyze stuff.
They seem more organic than mineral, Captain. It's a female of its race, Captain. I'm afraid my tricorder doesn't have much information on Furians.
What about these gems?
Captain, this stone has a cell structure. It must be organic. It also has a wave signature indicative of some sort of psionic abilities.
Psionic and organic. I'm so glad that Chekov and Sulu are getting so much more lines here. And all of them are, actually, but...
Captain, this stone has a cell structure.
Same.
Captain, this stone has...
Just checking.
Captain, this stone has... Captain, I'm detecting a large quantity of these blue stones underneath the surface in this spot. Now, this is strange. According to the tricorder, everything around us is organic.
But it feels like minerals to me.
Tricorders don't lie, Pop.
It could be a deception, Captain.
What'd he say? If we're in another universe?
Now this is...
But it feels like minerals.
Tricorders don't lie, Pop.
It could be a deception, Captain.
Perhaps our conventional definitions don't apply.
Captain, it's as if nothing's there.
I didn't think there could be a bigger wasteland than Siberia.
Anything about this?
Although it looks like common dirt.
Nope. Alright. Thoughts, gentlemen?
I wonder how many other universes like this one exist, connected to ours by a thread.
According to Professor Tomao's theory, that would be dependent on the number of dimensions shared by the two universes.
But Professor Ondiango's theory would contradict this.
Ondiango has never proven his theory.
But Tamao's theory doesn't explain slingshot effects.
Gentlemen, it was a rhetorical question.
I hope the inhabitants of this dimension don't mind visitors.
Let's find Spock and get out of here quickly.
You aren't scared, are you?
Not at all. The Russians are just an efficient and very sensible people.
These people always taking shots at each other. Look at that.
Starfleet. What a career move. I really have been where no man has gone before.
Okay.
Save new game. Replace pre-
new game before I start messing with stuff. Can we take these things?
Why are you reaching for your phaser, Mr. Sulu?
Captain.
Walker, I saw you sneaking up on me.
Sir.
You're all against me.
What?
You've gotten rid of Spock, now me. Who's next? Scotty? Uhura? Or are they part of this too?
Captain, snap out of it.
Something is definitely wrong, such intense emotions.
Ha! All from picking up this stone?
An odd orange gemstone.
We get any new reading here.
That's interesting. These stones check out as organic matter.
So evidently it's controlling his mind to some degree or something?
What are we doing here? Why did we come here?
Captain?
There's no way back. We'll never find Spock. We're trapped here forever, and it's all my fault. I knew the Antares Rift was dangerous. I should never have let the ship go in there.
Captain?
But let's find Spock.
Okay. So, suspicion. Despair. What's this one? Sadness? Blue?
This place reminds me of Denema. I lost my brother there. He was a few years younger than I was, and there were times when he annoyed me.
Captain?
And now he's gone. Gone. I'll never see him again. Never tell him... Tell him...
Captain, snap out of it.
This place must be getting to me.
That is like sadness.
An odd orange gemstone.
I think it's the one we had already.
A blue gemstone, similar to a sapphire.
An emerald, but the albedo doesn't look right. Oh, we're missing voiceovers in some of this episode.
That's interesting. That's interesting.
Should we take this one? So we got this red one too, and all those blue ones. How's it gonna flip out now?
Don't worry, Mr. Walker, I'll protect you.
Sir?
Sulu, Checo. You know, I may never have told you this before, but I care for you all more than I can tell.
Aww.
Sulu, with your dedication, your unwavering sense of responsibility.
Captain, are you talking about me?
Checo, I've always been impressed by your enthusiasm, all those wonderful Russian jokes, your humanity.
Captain?
And you, Mr.
Walker, love stone.
With your rugged determination, I'll bet you had more girlfriends than anyone in the history of the Academy.
Actually, sir, I'm celibate.
What was I just saying?
Wow. Cool. Alright. Interesting. Very, very interesting. What did we just pick up? Yellow.
A yellow gemstone. If this was your universe, you'd think it was topaz.
Same description, I guess.
That's interesting.
Yep.
I'll get them, Captain.
You're gonna get them? Oh, what are you gonna do now? You're gonna kill us all?
Wait, we need something to handle them with. Mr. Walker, handling single stones produced intense emotions. A cache of these stones.
You're right, sir.
I thought he was going to do it anyway.
Save new game.
Now, I wonder if we had gone for these stones first. We wouldn't have known that.
Replace pre...
I'll get them, Captain.
Wait, we need some...
You're right, sir.
We need something to hold him.
Kirk to Enterprise. Come in, Enterprise.
The communicators are functioning perfectly, Captain. It's as though there's nothing to talk with.
Or talk to. Oh yeah, we didn't get this one. And we still have to try to interact with the alien in some way.
I heard that, Mr. Sulu.
I didn't say anything.
You've always been saying things behind my back. You've always said I don't have enough discipline, that I don't respect my crew. You're insubordinate, Mr. Sulu.
Get hold of yourself, Captain.
What on earth was I saying? I'm sorry, Mr. Sulu, that was not...
Captain, I think we better get out of here as soon as possible.
That's funny. That's very interesting. Eyes.
A red gemstone, similar to a ruby.
Scanning it probably... reveals the same result.
that's interesting.
Yep. What if you try to get these rocks?
They're a little large, Captain. They're a little large, Captain.
He's a little large, Cap.
They're a little large, Captain.
Greetings. I come in the name of your United Federation of Planets.
Greetings, Lord Kirk.
Ooh.
I am Imanata.
Imanata.
I regret the discomfort that I put you through on your ship. I wish only to preserve my joy by serving the Savant.